So one of the things that has always grabbed my attention since all the years I've been here is that everything is privatized. Healthcare is privatized. Education is privatized. Water is privatized. And you have, depending on the market conditions, it depends what, how much you pay. One of the things that, as a parent here, I've had to send my kids to private schools in order to be able to try and guarantee some sort of level of decent quality education for them. And you have to pay for everything, for the books, for the all the materials that they use in the classroom. And that's one of the things that people are out are protesting for today. This is the second week, Friday, and it marks exactly 2 weeks since the beginning of the protest. And there is as powerful as ever. Here we are, Piazza Italia again. There's absolutely everybody out here with flags, with Mapuche flags, with Chilean flags. People are here with things to cover their faces because they know that there's going to be some sort of, there's going to be tear gas. There's going to be, at some stage, things are going to get probably ugly again. But they don't care. They're here. And they're shouting as loud at the top of their voices that they want some sort of change. They want real, profound changes to this new liberal economic model that was installed during the Pinochet dictatorship, and they want something to change. They need, I don't know, higher taxes on the rich, whatever. Perhaps things aren't that clear, but what is clear that they definitely want, they don't want to continue the way things are at the moment. And I think these protests are going to continue for I don't know how long. We've already seen the APEC and the COP have been cancelled. I don't know what else will be cancelled, but the protests continue, and I can already feel the tear gas in my nose, so we're probably going to have to do it soon.